This is Marcus Jade. You can find me on Instagram at Marcus Jade Music. You can also find my music at marcusjade.bandcamp.com. Also, for exclusive content, interviews, paintings, and exclusive things as far as music and even poetry, you can find that on patreon.com/MarcusJade. I have many subscribers and counting, and we have an amazing time connecting and sharing all over the world.
I'm always scared of the night, thinking somebody's coming after me. But it never ever serves me right, leaves me there suffering. Just try to write a simple song to talk about my loneliness.
I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana, and I wanted to talk about what did it for me when it comes to wanting to play music. And what was the thing that got me into just wanting to do what I do? And the scene of Indianapolis at that time, I was about 16 years old, and yeah, I had two friends invite me to this place called the Halloween House. It was somewhere in Broad Ripple, I would say more close to a little bit like Old Meridian, Sobro area. And we were going to this underground house party extravaganza. And the thing that really made me just absorb the entire scene was just the fact that, like, you know, there was so much going on, but then there was also this sense of camaraderie, this sense of peace and community. And it almost didn't even matter who played, but the people that played, I remember, was Highway Magic in this band called Bullet Wolf. And this was a night of just like pure hardcore adrenaline, heavy metal, PBRs, and just like loud music. And like I said, I was a young cat, and I was like absorbed, and that did it for me. I would also say too that, like, my brother as well as a string of cousins were all these aspiring musicians, when I, surprisingly, at a time wasn't really interested in pursuing music as much as they were. And this was probably about 2 years before this magical night. And all my cousins and my brother, they were very into hip-hop. And the biggest thing that I was astounded and captured by was this was like the first or the second generation of people that were trying to take hold of their own content. And so my brother, he had this tape deck that he used, and then he used another tape deck to record himself as well as have the music playing in the background. And that was innovative to me. That was completely next level, and that inspired me more so than anything else. I would love to tell my brother that it was really him that influenced me so much more than all the nights that I ever spent somewhere was where I wasn't supposed to be, in somebody's basement, listening to all these different bands that were coming from the Midwest. And I had my own scene, and I think that that was something that kind of helped me differentiate myself around my peers, as well as almost just make me a little bit like happy that like it was an escape, because geographically I'm from the west side of Indianapolis, 38th and High School, and everywhere that like all these shows were located at was somewhere like in Broad Ripple, Fountain Square, Irving neighborhoods, and just a little bit more east. And so all these places were just like far away from me. And with everything that was going on the west side, you know, going to these shows was an escape. But my brother too, like I said, was, I think he had set a tone for me of just reminding myself that like, we can do this. We can do this by ourselves. We can do this. We can do this ourselves. This was something beyond DIY for me, because a lot of these places in the scene where I was probably the only black person there, the only black kid there, and I didn't care. I knew that I was well aware of where I stood and who these people were. But what kind of bothered me was the sense of feeling like they had access to more resources that gave them initiative. And when I saw my brother do the thing of just like try to record and put these tapes together and mix them all through like these series of tape decks, that's what really set it off for me. And I love my brother. He's still alive. I love him very much. And he doesn't do music anymore. And as adamant as I've been about music the past, since I was 16, like, I often wonder why he didn't do it. But I'm glad that, like, I do it because of him. And I'm glad that I do it because all these times that I spent in houses in Broad Ripple and Fountain Square, all of that really translated to what's going on now and how I very really fashioned my own career. I was just knowing that like there is the scene, there is the DIY community, and there was never any real trend. It's what it is. It's tradition. It's the way that we as musicians really should go, is to the grassroots level, and just even if you want to stay there, stay there. If you want to go far and you want to make a lot of like likes or money or something like that, then yeah, there's that avenue too. But I think that like that community, that DIY community, that's a staple, and that's no matter what happens in your life, you could still always kind of go back. Even if those places don't exist anymore, you can still go back to that feeling and that camaraderie. And that's what Indianapolis even instilled in me. Of all the places that I played in the country, there was Indianapolis's scene was the most eclectic for me. And to this day, I just wish that like I could be more active in that community as well as in the scene everywhere else.
See, this is a time for our CEO. So just ease your breath, your restless soul.
October 10th, I will be performing at Porch Stomp. It is in Governor's Island, New York. And I love for you to hear more about it. Go to porchstomp.com to learn more about the really nice event that's going to go down. Thank you.
See, heaven is real. It's in your eyes. God is a woman.